Calvary's love. Calvary's love. Calvary's love. Calvary's love. There's a river of love flowing down from above. Calvary's love. Calvary's love. Unconditional love, unconditional love. There's a river of love flowing down from above. Unconditional love, Holy Spirit, unconditional love, love through me, love through me, love. Love through me, love through me, love through me, love through me. From above, love through me, Holy Spirit, love through me. Just before our sister Lois step back to read Isaiah 58. The Lord had already spoken to me to read it. That you pour out your souls to feed the afflicted. A very well-known minister that's gone through a hard time called me several days ago. He said he was walking along the beach in the midst of his difficulties. And suddenly the Lord said, if you'll get back to pouring out your soul to the afflicted, I'll cause your light to rise in obscurity. Sometimes we're very conscious of our light arising, but it comes as we pour out our soul to the needy and to the afflicted. I feel that this morning is part of the preparation of the Holy Spirit for our partaking of the Lord's Supper together, as we are conscious of the needs of others. Hallelujah. And we come and partake together. Hallelujah. We're going to prepare our hearts. Those that are at the altar, you don't need to go back. Just stay where you are. You can be served communion at that point as well as where you are. I just want to read from Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 53. As we're preparing our hearts. For he shall grow up before him as a tender plant, and as a root out of a dry ground. He hath no form nor comeliness, and when we shall see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. He is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief, and we hid, as it were, our faces from him. He was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he hath borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned every one to his own way, and the Lord hath laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He is brought as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before her shearers is dumb, so he openeth not his mouth. He was taken from prison and from judgment, and who shall declare his generation? For he was cut off out of the land of the living. For the transgression of my people was he stricken. And he made his grave with the wicked, and with the rich in his death, because he had done no violence, neither was any deceit in his mouth. Yet it pleased the Lord to bruise him. He hath put him to grief. And when thou shalt make his soul an offering for sin, he shall see his seed. He shall prolong his days. And the pleasure of the Lord shall prosper in his hand. He shall see of the travail of his soul and shall be satisfied. And by his knowledge shall my righteous servants justify many. For he shall bear their iniquities. Therefore will I divide him a portion with the great. And he shall divide the spoil with the strong. Because he hath poured out his soul unto death, he was numbered with the transgressors, and he bare the sin of many, and made intercession for the transgressors. Reading from 1 Corinthians chapter 11. beginning with verse 23, for I have received of the Lord.